In this lecture, we're going to continue with the rest of the 4th dynasty, otherwise known as the Golden Age of the Pyramids. We're going to start with Khufu, who was the son of Seneferu and the builder of the Great Pyramid of Giza. King Khufu built the first of the 3 pyramids of Giza for his tomb. Although his pyramid has survived so long, many other aspects of his rule are unknown. The only full portrait of the king is a 3-inch-high ivory figurine, which was found in Abydos. His royal serac was found on the back, and it depicts a king wearing the red crown of Lower Egypt and holding a flail. It was originally found headless, but Flinders Petrie insisted that the head be found, which it was 3 weeks later. This piece could be contemporary to Khufu's rule, or it could have been a reproduction from the 26th dynasty. As a king, Khufu sent several expeditions to collect materials such as turquoise and copper. He also kept in contact with the ancient city-state of Byblos, especially to trade copper tools and weapons for Lebanon cedar wood. Wood is a very difficult material to obtain in Egypt because the trees that grow in Egypt are very thin and not good for building. Khufu needed the cedar wood for building funerary boats. Although it is highly debated how the pyramids were built, they were most likely built by using ramps up the side to bring blocks to the upper portion of the pyramid. The stones are also brought from the quarries in the south by boats on the Nile. From the recent excavations in the workers' villages in Giza, it has been revealed that the pyramids have been built by conscripted workers. These were probably farmers who needed work. They would bring their families to stay at the site, and they were paid for their work with food. Papyrus fragments have been discovered containing lists of those who were paid. The pyramid was most likely built in a 10 to 20 year period. Like some of the previous pyramids, it was originally covered in Tura white limestone, which gave it a smooth and shiny surface. There are approximately 2.3 million stones in the Great Pyramid of Giza. The interior of the pyramid is fascinating. There are both interior and underground rooms. The lower chamber, which is underneath the pyramid, was not completed. It was thought to be the original burial chamber for Khufu, but he may have later changed his mind. There's also a room called the Queen's Chamber, which is a simple room off of the Grand Gallery. The entrance of the pyramid leads up to the Grand Gallery, which is a 30-foot sloping chamber which leads to the King's Chambers. The entrance of the pyramid leads to the Grand Gallery, which is a 30-foot sloping chamber. This leads to the King's Chamber, which is entirely faced in granite and contains a granite sarcophagus that was looted in antiquity. The sarcophagus is actually bigger than the entrance to the room, indicating that it had to have been placed there before the roof was put in place. Above the King's Chambers are 5 compartments called the Reliving Chambers. The first 4 are short, flat-roofed chambers, with the last one having a pointed roof. It is believed that these chambers were made to safeguard the king's burial chamber in case the roof collapsed. These rooms bear marks from different work gangs that helped build them. There are also many quote-unquote air shafts, which might actually not be air shafts at all. Over the years, many archaeologists and scientists have tried to reveal where these shafts go, often using robots with cameras and lights. Many have been discovered to be blocked off somewhere in the middle, so the reasoning for their existence is still unclear. Finally, in 2017, scientists from a group called Scan Pyramids discovered a large cavity above the Grand Gallery using radiography. It is at least 30 meters, or 98 feet long. It could have possibly been a gap that was used to construct the Grand Gallery, but is yet to be, nor may never be, properly assessed. The pyramid complex itself is massive. It contains several buildings, including many of the satellite pyramids we talked about last lecture. The satellite pyramids can also be called Queen's Pyramids. There are currently 3 preserved and 1 in ruins. The mortuary temple and causeway of Khufu's pyramid are barely preserved, and the valley temple is most likely buried under the modern village of Nazlat el-Saman. Around the pyramid, 3 boat-shaped pits were also found, although they were found empty. In 1954, a 4th pit was discovered with 1,224 pieces of wood. The pieces were put together and conserved over the course of 14 years. This resulted in a 143-foot or 43.6-meter long cedar boat. The timbers are entirely held together by rope. The boat is located in the Giza Solar Boat Museum, and during the construction of this museum, another sealed boat pit was found and later excavated. These boats were buried here so that King Khufu could sail away to the afterlife like the god Horus. Khufu had multiple known children, possibly 9 sons and 5 daughters. It is possible that his eldest son was named Khawab, but he died before Khufu did, so he never inherited the throne. The throne most likely went to another one of Khufu's sons, Jedef Rey. Jedef Rey married his brother's widow, Heta Pharis II, who was also his sister. They had at least 4, if not 6 children, none of which actually inherited the throne. He most likely only ruled for about 10 to 11 years. Jedef Rey did build a pyramid in Abu Roash, which is north of Giza. It is unfortunately now ruined, but excavations indicate that it was completed. The complex had a pyramid, a mud brick mortuary temple, an enclosure wall, and a causeway, but there is no indication of a valley temple. A sphinx of his wife, Heta Pharis I, was also found in the complex and is thought to be the first sphinx created in Egypt. There are some that believe that Jedef Rey built the sphinx in Giza, but this is not proven. It is unclear why, but Jedef Rey's successor was his brother Khafre and not one of his sons. Khafre had several wives, one of which was his sister Khammer-er-Nebti I, who was his principal wife and the mother of his heir Menkaure. He had at least 12 sons and 3 to 4 daughters. His pyramid is directly south of Khufu's and is the second tallest in Giza. Again, like Khufu's pyramid, this pyramid was most likely robbed in antiquity, with the casing stones most likely being reused in the New Kingdom. The casing of the pyramid is only preserved in the uppermost part. The interior of this pyramid is much more simple than the Great Pyramid. There are 2 entrances that led to a burial chamber, which is at the ground level. A subsidiary chamber, which may have been used to store offerings, burial equipment, or as a serdab chamber, opens up from the passage. The burial chamber is carved out of a pit in the bedrock, and the roof is constructed with gabled limestone beams. A sarcophagus was found in this chamber that was made out of a single block of granite. The pyramid complex follows the same pattern as all the rest of the pyramids. There was one small satellite pyramid on the south side. This is mostly in ruins, but at one point had 2 descending passages. The mortuary temple and valley temples are in much better condition than Khufu's pyramid. The mortuary temple is now in ruins, but enough survives to see that it was larger than previous temples and included an entrance hall, a columned court, 5 niches for statues of the pharaoh, 5 storage chambers, and an inner sanctuary. There should have been at least 50 statues of Khafre, but they seem to be reused by later pharaohs. A causeway led to the valley temple. This is built out of megalithic blocks of red granite, and the floor is made out of paved alabaster. There would have been holes in the ceiling, which would have lit up the smooth alabaster floor. The large pillared hall would have held 23 statues of Khafre, although only 1 survives. This statue is made out of a stone called gneiss, which was mined 600 miles away. This rock glows a blue hue when in strong sunlight, so the statue would have looked remarkable on top of the bright alabaster floors. In this statue, Khufu is wearing a Nemi's headdress, which is a royal striped headcloth. A falcon is sitting behind his head, hugging him with his wings. This is to indicate that the king is the living god Horus, who is usually depicted as a falcon. The Semitawi sign that I talked about last week is also shown on either side of the chair. This motif, again, is the symbol of the tying of a lily and papyrus plant, both of which are from Lower and Upper Egypt. It usually indicates a unification of both sides of Egypt. The one unique part of Khafre's complex is the Sphinx. A Sphinx is a mythical creature with the body of a lion and the head of a human. The face of the Giza Sphinx is generally believed to be Khafre himself. The Sphinx may have been created as a guardian of the pyramid, or as a symbol of royal power. Unlike the majority of other structures in Giza, the Sphinx was actually cut out of the bedrock. The nose of the Sphinx has probably been missing since about the 15th century, and there at one point was a pharaonic beard that was preserved and is now in the British Museum, though this may have been added at a later time. The Sphinx may also have been painted with red on the face and blue and yellow on other parts. Interestingly, the Sphinx does not appear in any known inscription from the Old Kingdom. There was also an associated Sphinx temple that was built from the rocks that were cut away from the Sphinx. In the New Kingdom, a stela, which is a large inscribed block, was built between the legs of the Sphinx. Khafre's heir was his son, named Menkaure. Menkaure built the third and smallest pyramid at Giza. The pyramid is constructed with limestone, red granite, and cased in the white Tura limestone, although this has not been preserved. The pyramid's burial chamber is completely underground, which helps simplify the construction of the pyramid. A wooden coffin from the late period was found in an antechamber, and a basalt sarcophagus with the bones of a young woman was found in the burial chamber. Unfortunately, the sarcophagus is now at the bottom of the Mediterranean Sea after it was lost with the ship Beatrice in 1838, though its lid survived and it is currently located at the British Museum. There are three satellite pyramids, which are each accompanied by its own mortuary temple and substructure. One of them is believed to belong to his wife, Khameyr-Nebti II. The mortuary temple's foundations were made of stone, but the walls were made of mud brick. This may have been because Menkaure died before the complex was finished, and his heir was trying to finish it in a hurry. The Valley Temple was also made out of mud brick. During excavations of the Valley Temple, many statues of Menkaure were discovered. The statue on the left is an uninscribed statue of Menkaure and an unknown woman. The unknown woman could be his wife, Khameyr-Nebti II, his mother, Khameyr-Nebti I, or the goddess Hathor. The statue on the right is called the Menkaure Triad. This statue features Menkaure, the goddess Hathor, and the goddess of the Bat Gnome, which was a cow goddess. These two statues are now in the Cairo Museum. These statues are both made out of a stone called gray wacke, but they were most likely plastered and then painted. And finally, in the middle is a statue of Menkaure, which is over life size, even though the head is out of proportion of the body. This is because the sculptors found a fault in the limestone after they began carving the statue. Interestingly, even though Menkaure had an elder son named Khnumre, his son Shepseskaf inherited the throne. None of the wives or children of Shepseskaf are known. He did not build a pyramid like his predecessors, but instead built himself a grand mastaba. There are some theories as to why he did not build himself a pyramid. 1. He may have been too busy finishing his father Menkaure's pyramid, so he just decided to build himself a mastaba. 2. He could have built a mastaba to undermine the growing influence of the priesthood of the god Re. 3. He could have been copying the early dynastic tradition of mastabas. And 4. He could have died before the building of a tomb, so his wife or heir had to build a mastaba for him. The mastaba has an underground chamber made of granite, and there were remains of a basalt or gray wacke sarcophagus. The tomb also had two enclosure walls made of mud brick, a small funerary chapel, and the upper portions of a causeway. Before we end this lecture today, I also want to point out some non-royal sculpture from this period. This statue depicts a dwarf named Pernianku. He and his family worked for one of the kings of the 4th dynasty. He was described as one who delights his lord every day, and as the king's dwarf. This may have meant that he was like a jester or an entertainer for the king himself. Another dwarf that is known from the 4th dynasty is called Seneb. Seneb was a high-ranking court official from the reigns of Khufu and Djedefre. He may have actually been related to Pernianku, as their tombs are very close to each other in Giza. He was the director of dwarves and in charge of the king's wardrobe. Dwarves were obviously very much respected during this time, as they had multiple different titles. This statue of Seneb, his wife, and children was found in a limestone box in his tomb in Giza. His two children are pictured below him. He had a son named Regedef Ankh and a daughter named Atib Khufu. Parts of both of his children's names are the kings that Seneb served under. These children are depicted naked with one finger in front of their mouths. Children are almost always depicted naked in Egyptian iconography, but that doesn't mean that they always ran around without clothes. This is just a simple way to identify who is a child versus an adult in Egyptian iconography. We don't exactly know what the finger in front of the mouth means, but we know that it is usually used to depict children and has been used since the pre-dynastic period. Next week, we are going to talk about the 5th and 6th dynasties of the Old Kingdom. These kings still built pyramids, so don't forget the vital components of a pyramid complex. Thanks, and stay safe.